Coming to the next point, in the architecture of 8086, let us we discuss in detail in the bus interface unit functions. We have a microprocessor like this 8086 microprocessor. This 8086 microprocessor which is connected to the memory device, right? This is the memory device. So from the memory, information will pass to the microprocessor as well as from the 8086 microprocessor to the memory, it will send bidirectionally with the address as well as the data. And similarly, we just connected input and output devices to the microprocessor as well as the microprocessor will send information through the output devices. Like that, from the external peripheral devices to the microprocessor as well as microprocessor to the external peripheral devices, information will pass out. So whenever the information passed out from the memory devices to the microprocessor, that is called memory read operation. If the information is passed from the microprocessor to the memory, that is called memory write operation. As well as, if you are putting some information from the keyboard, that will send to the 8086 microprocessor, that means I/O reading operation. If the microprocessor will send information to the display devices through the I/O devices, that is called I/O write operation. So memory read, memory write, I/O read and I/O write, these are the four essential control signals will be necessary to send the address as well as the data. That information you can read here. It sends address of the memory or I/O. So CPU will send the address of the memory or the address of the I/O. That is first point. Second point, instructions are coming from the memory to the microprocessor. So it fetches the instructions from the memory. So the instructions are coming from the memory to the microprocessor. In the microprocessor, it fetches the instructions, means that it reads the instructions. Third point, it read or write data from port or memory. So from the memory to the microprocessor, we cannot directly send. In between, we can use the ports. Similarly, we can use the ports between the I/O device and the 8086 microprocessor. So if you want to send the information from I/O devices to the 8086, we have to use the ports. As well as from the memory to 8086, we have to use ports or CPU interface. So reading means that memory to 8086 processor, as well as writing means that 8086 to memory devices, as well as from the data will be transferred from the input to 8086 microprocessor is a reading operation. From 8086 to output devices is a writing operation. So reading and writing of the data from the port or from the memory will also, it is one of the function. And it provides address relocation facility. This is important function we have in the bus interface unit. Sometimes we are working with a multiprocessor system. During the multiprocessing system or in multi-programming purpose, we can send this program to another segment. Like that, to relocate the programs, we can use the address relocation facility. Later we will see all these things. It supports instruction queuing. In the 8085 microprocessor, we don't have a queue, but in 8086 microprocessor, it supports queuing system, means that the instructions are flooded or prefetched in the queue. So we have a 6 bytes long queue in the 8086 architecture. So the instructions are flooded into the queue. So 6 bytes of the long instructions are just stored into the queue. Finally, I can say the bus interface unit is taking care of performing all the external bus operations, and it also provides bidirectional address bus and data bus. So the bus interface unit is the first part. We have a microprocessor. In the microprocessor, we have a bus interface unit and a execution unit. So memory interface will be connected to the bus interface unit. So the memory will be directly connected to the bus interface unit initially. So bus interface unit is taking care of all the external bus operations, and it provides a bidirectional address and data bus. From the memory device, maybe the addresses will be send it to the bus interface unit, and the bus interface unit will send the address to the memory devices. So bidirectionally, address as well as the data will be sent from the memory to the microprocessor as well as the microprocessor to the memory. These are the main functions which are involved in the bus interface unit. Let us go through the what are the sub parts are there in the bus interface unit. One is address summer, means that a dedicated adder which was indicated by the sigma. A dedicated adder will be used for accessing the 1 MB memory. To access this 1 MB memory, we have to provide a 20-bit address. So to generate this 20 bit address, we use the address summer or a dedicated adder. So one adder will be provided in the bus interface unit. A dedicated adder will be used to generate a 20 bit address. If two numbers are added, it will generate a 20 bit address. This 20 bit address has given the facility to access the 1 MB memory. To access the 1 MB memory, we need to generate a 20 bit address. To generate 20 bit address, this address summer will does that duty. Next point is that maximum all the registers or a memory pointed to the 16 bit address actually, but we have to make the 16 bit address into 20 bit address for accessing the 1 MB memory. In fact, we can use the some sort of registers like code segment register, data segment register, stack segment register and extra segment register. All these are 16 bit registers. So this is 16 bit registers or 16 bit address will be provided, like suppose 1234H. This is 16 bit register pointed to the code segment register. So to generate this 16 bit register, 16 bit address into 20 bit address, we need to multiply with the 10H value, or we have to add last four digits. Let us take 1234H. 1 means that 0001, 2 means that 0010, 3 means that 0011, 4 means that 0100. So these are the 16 bits actually. To make the 20 bit, we have to append 4 zeros at the lower side. So if you append 4 zeros, this makes the 20 bit address. Like that you can generate 20 bit address using the dedicated adder. So coming to this 1234H, this is the 16 bit address. By multiplying with the 10H value, we will be changing the total value is 12340H. So this is the segment base actually we treated like that. This is the segment base, whether it is a code segment or a data segment or extra segment or stack segment, whatever it is the segment that you provided here, that will be treated as a segment base. Later we will see this thing also in the next sessions. Now let us go through the instruction queue. We have a instruction queue or a queue in a bus interface unit. What is the purpose of this queue? Just let them have a look. The prefetched instruction bytes are held for execution unit in a group of registers is called queue. So the instructions are coming from the memory to the microprocessor, particularly in bus interface unit. In the bus interface unit, the instructions are held at the queue in a group of registers. The queue is operated under the principle of FIFO. FIFO means that first in, first out. So the queue will be look like this. If the instructions are coming into this first queue, so it will be stored here. If the next instruction is coming, this will be loaded into this one and this will be loaded into this one. Like that, finally, the first instruction will be coming out from the decoding unit and to the execution unit in execution unit. So whenever the first instruction is coming, that will be coming out at the output side. So first in, first out. You can treat this one as an opcode fetch FIFO buffer, because we enter some instructions in the micro in the software that will generate an opcode for every instructions. So the op prefetched into the queue. So this will be treated as an opcode fetch FIFO buffer. So why we are putting this queue is that the number of instructions are readily placed into the queue. So it is possible to fetch the next instruction when the current instruction is in execution. Suppose the instruction is fetched and it is sent to the decoding and execution unit. In the execution unit, it is always ready to take the instructions from the queue. So meanwhile, the instructions are flooded into the queue. So with the help of queue, it is possible to fetch the next instruction when the current instruction is execution. By the way, this instruction queue is having a 6 bytes long ahead of time from the memory to speed up the program execution. And one thing you have to notice that if the one instruction may takes 6 bytes long, so in entire queue maybe it saves one instruction. In sometimes one instruction may take 1 byte, and sometimes then one instruction take 2 bytes, some instructions one instruction take 3 bytes. Like that, depending on the size of the instruction, the queue may be empty or partially empty or maybe totally full. It depends on the instruction size. But the designers have been designed optimum length of the queue is 6 bytes long. So the execution unit gets ready for executing the instructions if it is available in the queue. Whenever the instructions are prefetched in the queue, then always execution unit ready to take the instructions to execute. Due to the availability of the instructions which are stored in the FIFO buffer, fetching speed is eliminated. So always execution unit is ready to take the instructions so that whenever the instructions are coming frequently and saved at the queue, then execution will take the instructions obviously, so that the cannot find the ideal time to the 8086 microprocessor like in 8085 microprocessor. And coming to this queue length is depends on the fetching speed and execution speed, also may be restricted. We may be restricted this queue is somewhat 6 bytes long and 4 bytes long. Sometimes what happened, non-availability of the CPU chip, then queue length may be decreased. So you can decrease the queue length, that depends on the fetching speed and execution speed. If you are providing some faster execution speed as well as fetching speed, if you are increasing, then there may be a facility to decrease the queue length. But the designers here in 8086 has been designed optimum length of the queue is 6 bytes long. In particular, what happened while executing the programs, particularly in jump and call instructions, the program has been jumped from the queue and it forms a new address. That means that you are doing some programs, at the middle of the program if you write jump to some 3000H memory location, so it jumps to the new address and attend to the interrupt service routine, means that a sub program, if it completed, then it is come to the where you stop the program before that address, it continuously goes on. So particularly in jump and call instructions, it is the queue is flushed out all the things and just coming to the, it starts to the new address pointed by the jump and call instructions.